rabbit was stuck in Genom, for he had destroyed every coordinate and links that led to his quantum jumper, which made it impossible for him to travel or pass through the corridors of space to get to Earth. And the reason he embarked on this self-destructive mission, which backfired on him, was to prevent the Plutonian and his allies from going to Earth. But unfortunately for him, the Plutonian asked Malus to punch him back in time, in which the Plutonian went back in time, took his allies, and departed to Earth. In so doing, leaving Qubit, Modius, and Malus behind. Not too long after, Modius' consciousness departed and left Modius' android, and its mechanical body fell apart, which is unknown to the Plutonian that Modius transferred his consciousness into the body of Cutter. Now, Qubit was left with a disheartened and disheveled Malus, who was disappointed that he was left behind, and in hoping to build a portal to get to Earth, Malus was of no use, for he was emotionally distraught. So Qubit had to build a new machine on his own. But in reality, this will take years. And this was Qubit being realistic with himself. But with Malus's shortcoming as an individual, he had abilities that is beneficiary to Qubit's mission in going back home. So the ever-intelligent Qubit delimited the time travel frequency of Malus, making him more powerful by channeling and tweaking his bioenergy to create a week-long loop of multiple copy of himself from the past to his present state. If Malus could have endured the process, he could have filled Genom with multiple copy of himself, and in weeks, his multiple present past selves helped him build a new portal back to Earth. On getting back to Earth, Qubit found out that things had turned out worse than he left for Genom. Apart from the Plutonian's rampage, which had become the norm, Qubit realized that the planet was facing something far worse than the Plutonian, and it was the radiation consuming the Earth. And this deadly wave of intense radiation was coming straight for America in a matter of days. And once Qubit acquired and assessed the data of this coming catastrophic event, he realized that even though the fatality spread is low, those that survive it are doomed, for they will end up dying a very slow death. And between now and the third generation, humanity and life will cease to exist. Everything will be extinct. The Plutonian simply replied Qubit. So, a furious Max Damage went mad. He wanted to knock the Plutonian out, but Qubit stopped him. Believing that Qubit brought Max Damage as his muscle, told Max Damage that he is not afraid of him, that he used to be a threat, but since he had gone all goody two shoes, he is no match for him now that he had evolved. For the Plutonian could feel an improvement within himself, in which Qubit equally agreed from his observation since they left the timeless zone. Qubit telling the Plutonian that his evolution is what is going to save the world. But a nonchalant Plutonian was jokingly threatening to atomize Qubit, wondering why Qubit thinks he is in any mood to save Earth. Qubit let the Plutonian know that he had found out how his powers work, and also his newfound powers he discovered in the timeless zone, that he can help him in training him on how to use his powers at its full potentials. The Plutonian replied Qubit that what if he uses his psychic abilities to retrieve this information from Qubit's brain and drop kick both him and Max Damage into the sun. So Qubit told the Plutonian not to underestimate him, that for 20 years he had built psionic shields in his mental faculty, which prevents people with psychic powers like Burrows to read his mind, for his major concern is the safety of humanity, and that he plans in saving everyone, in which it is complex, and despite many times he had done his calculation in saving the world, he can't do it without the help of the Plutonian. So he offered the Plutonian a deal, something deep in the Plutonian's heart he had always longed for, a second chance, in which if he helps him in saving the world, he promised to turn back the clock for Anthony Dan Hartigan, in which he can start all over again and live right. For in all sincerity, Qubit believes the Plutonian deserves a second chance, in which the Plutonian believes that Qubit was referring to Malus, a chronokinetic being whom had the ability to send a person back in time. And the Plutonian, who is now interested, is convinced that Qubit knows how to harness Malus's energy. In hearing this, Mark Damage turned his anger on Qubit, forsaking the Plutonian's antics, that he must be insane for Qubit to trust the Plutonian in making him more powerful, and worst of all, sending him back in time, in which he believes that the Plutonian is not repentant and he is capable of double-crossing Qubit. For it is in his nature for Mark Damage see the Plutonian as a nutcase, and in anger, Mark Damage left Qubit with the Plutonian and returned to Colesville. Knowing that they had failed in their mission in stopping the Plutonian with the help of Elliot, who had lost his powers due to the demise of Charybdis alias Survivor, Gigamos led Scylla and Kaidan to the deep core of Iran, beneath the surface of the country, looking for the tree of life. For according to the biblical history, the Garden of Eden was situated in Iran, the birthplace of humanity. Then it was known as Mesopotamia historically. Scylla was still furious at Gilgamesh for killing the Survivor, for he believes Gilgamesh rushed into judgment, for he understood that Survivor was under a lot of pressure from guilt about his death and his failed promises to the people. He also believes that Gilgamesh never consulted them before taking action, as he believes that they were a team. And to be frank and to be honest, Gilgamesh was sorry for his mistake, in which Kaidan came to Gilgamesh's defense that Gilgamesh did what was right at that time. But what was more important to Gilgamesh was to find a solution to detoxify the radiation from the atmosphere, as the world may come to an end. Scylla and Gilgamesh settled their differences, for in a way, and being realistic to himself, Scylla understood that at that time Gilgamesh had no choice, and the mission at hand was more important for humanity, and that is to look and find the old tree of life, in which they found as they dig the ground near the tree, as they found seeds from the tree of life. The Plutonian had agreed to work with Qubit in helping to stop the spread of the radiation, under the promise made to him that he can turn back the clock of time on his behalf. Now, for the Plutonian to be able to stop the radiation, Qubit understands the process behind the powers of the Plutonians, and he will have to train him in utilizing his powers beyond its capabilities. For as much powerful and intelligent Anthony Dan Hartigan is, one thing that baffles Qubit is that he lacked a sense of curiosity about himself. For if the Plutonian really took time to understand his powers, he would have been equal to a god. But in all reality, Qubit saw this as a blessing in disguise. For the blatant truth is that Anthony Dan Hartigan's abilities redefine everything man knows about science, in which, to a large extent, it boils down to him being able to nullify fundamental force. He was trained by Qubit to use his powers through his psychic abilities, in which he was able to stop the moon from spinning by sheer will of his thoughts, and caused an explosion with a snap of his finger. Now, Qubit was a bit wary of the Plutonian turning on him, for he can be unpredictable. With his newfound powers, the Plutonian was able to draw out rare elements from Earth in large quantities, mold them into alloys in space to Qubit's specifications, and it was to be used in filtering the radiation from the atmosphere. Typical of him, the Plutonian was mischievously throwing the alloys in a near-miss situation out of spite, because he was taking orders from Qubit, for he was excited about his newfound powers. But all in all, in everything they had done in stopping the radiation, Qubit's calculation failed. Now, the problem Qubit was facing was not knowing the source and origin of the radioactive field, for he had no information how it was created. For whatever this radioactive field is, it is not playing by his calculated rules. Now, the Plutonian knows that there is something more bothering Qubit apart from the radiation enveloping the globe, as he psychically tries his best to read Qubit's mind to see what more his friend of integrity is hiding. But Qubit told him to remember that he psionically shielded his mental faculty from him. Then he did a little research on those who built the radioactive field that trapped the Elias, and discovered that all of them had passed away, except one, a young intelligent boy who grew up to be the enigmatic, nefarious villain Modius. Then Qubit asked the Plutonian what he did with Modius. The Plutonian, not knowing the wiser, told him that the last time he came in contact with Modius was in an android's body in Genom, in which Qubit made the Plutonian aware that Modius has the ability to transfer his consciousness from one host to the other. At first, he thought he killed himself when he left the mechanical body of Modius android, but but then he suspected that he might have transferred his consciousness into one of his allies he brought to Earth. Just like that, it dawned on the Plutonian that when he and his allies went to confront Survivor and the new paradigm, Burroughs was ordered by the Survivor to read his mind. But for some reason, Burroughs in fear ran off to commit suicide. It didn't make any sense to him at that time. But now looking back at things on that day, he realized that Burroughs was not reading his mind. He was reading the mind of Carter, whom is being inhabited by Modius, as he remembered that he left Carter, whom is being inhabited by Modius, with Betty Noor. Immediately, the Plutonian flew away to look for them, not hearing when Cupid told him to wait. The Plutonian used his long view sight to locate Betty Noor, and he was sure that she is being inhabited by Modius. The Plutonian was right that there is more bothering Cupid apart from the radiation, and Cupid wasn't happy that he had to lie in getting the Plutonian's help, for it will be impossible to turn back the clock because Malus is dead.